And yo, how's it going, everyone? It's your boy Dom here, back in another brand new YouTube video for you guys today. And today, guys, as you guys can see by the title, we're going to be talking about the time I got caught by the cops. If you guys do enjoy this video, please leave a like, hit the sub button, and also hit the bell if you guys are new to not miss out on any videos. Because last video, boys, literally last video, it hasn't even been 24 hours since I'm recording this video, and it has over 120 views. You guys are fucking nuts. Thank you guys for all the support. Let's see if this video can get the same amount of love. And without further ado, let's get into this. So it all started off with me waking up for school and getting ready. And now the school day went along as like a normal day. And I'm not going to really explain what happened because it's not important. But after a long day of me wasting my life, I came back home to hit up the boys. And it was even like 30 or 40 minutes into the conversation when someone brought up the skate park. Now here's the problem with the skate park. There's always a cruiser just driving, okay? Just cruising around, making sure kids aren't doing anything bad. And even though it didn't really show up much, the cop was really just head ass about people smoking there. Probably to stop people like me and my friends. But we continue with the idea anyway. And of course, not even 20 minutes after this conversation goes by, everyone shows up. My friend who we're gonna call Lucas, he was in charge of holding the Za, the fucking loud pack, the Zaza pack. And honestly, looking back, we were probably smoking straight mids at the time. Mind you, this story took place a few years ago. The other friend who we're gonna call Josh, he was in charge of the Dutches. And then me. I was in charge of holding a joint, at least a joint. Because on this particular day, I wasn't really stocked up, and at the moment in time, I was running pretty low. But we get together and start heading to the skate park, and by the time like 15 minutes or so pass, Josh, he just looks like he's feeding. He keeps holding his backpack, and he keeps zipping and unzipping it. And mind you, cars are passing by, we're in a quiet-ass neighborhood. So looking at this from a third-person perspective, they're looking at this kid pretty sus, like, why does he keep opening and unzipping his backpack? But he was repeating that same exact motion for what felt like the entire walk, so it just looked kind of sus. Now, at this point, we were at the skate park, and we see two cruisers, which right away should have been a red flag to just leave and go somewhere else to smoke. But no, Lucas and Josh were determined to smoke these blunts right at this very moment. Like, if anyone was killing their high, it wasn't these cops. So we're at the benches, and Lucas whips out the blunt and says, "All right, boys, get ready." And I shit you not, Josh, with those words coming out of Lucas's mouth, he put the blunt in his mouth and sparked it up so fast, I couldn't believe it. We finished the blunts, and now all we have is my joint. By this point, we're all fried, but like, the champs that we were, we thought, you know what, let's spark up this last one for the boys. And I swear to God, as soon as the spark hit the paper, I already knew it was a mistake. Because as soon as that happened, I shit you not, two cops pulled up, sirens blasting. Now mind you, because I didn't mention this in the beginning of the video, but like, Josh, he isn't on the skinny side of things, okay? My man's a little bit chunky. And I've never seen someone at his size run as fast as he did. Like, I'm telling, he Usain Bolted the fuck out of there. I've never seen someone run as fast as he did in my entire life. And I want to say this right now. I already know that we could have just put up the joint and tossed the evidence, but that wasn't a thought that really crossed our mind in the moment, because Josh decided to book it without really saying anything. Like, literally, as soon as he heard the sirens, man dipped. So of course I go, "Yo, Josh, why'd you book it?" Like, they wouldn't have done anything but just tell us to leave and probably take our butt. They weren't able to see us from where they were pulled in because they had to come up the stairs to see into the skate park. And from where they were only able to probably see smoke and just barely, if that, because of the angle they were parked at. But after us arguing, we start heading out the woods from another exit we knew and thought it was all over. But as soon as we get out the exit, the two black cars with lights sitting on the rack, with the cops staring right at us, staring right at the exit, they tell us, "You three, come over here right now." At this point, we were too tired to run away. We just accepted the L. They explained to us how we shouldn't run from the cops and that they knew something was off because it smelled like weed the closer and closer they got to the park. So we were caught red-handed, and they didn't really give us the luxury of walking home. No, no, no. They dropped us all off home and told all of our parents the story. My parents were pissed, but it made for a good video. And on that note, hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you guys did, anyway, anyhow, please slap a like on it. I know I did a video before, and it did pretty good for when it came out and at the time of, like, my channel being, like, at, I think, 60 subs. But the quality of the video was absolute dog shit, and I just hope this one's a lot better. If there's one thing you guys should learn from this video, it's to not run away from the cops. don't do anything I said in this video. And yeah, it's been your boy Dom. I'm out. Peace.
Don't let them niggas tell you you can't do this shit, nigga.